The Department of Agriculture is studying the possibility of giving fuel subsidy to fishermen affected by the oil spill in Bataan Province. Secretary Francisco Tularell Jr., however, says there is no need to implement a fishing ban in the area just yet. The agency is also trying to find alternative livelihood that can be offered to affected fishermen using the Quick Response Fund. Meanwhile, the Agri Chief also clarifying there is no official report from the local authorities in Tarlac that there is indeed a bird flu outbreak in the area. The DA had earlier identified 3 farms in Tarlac under validation for a possible bird flu. The Philippine Finance Chief Ralph Recto defending the move to finance government projects using PhilHealth's unutilized funds. Speaking before a Senate panel, Recto said the move is adherent to Congress's order under the General Appropriations Act of 2024, emphasizing that the benefits and contributions of PhilHealth members will remain untouched. He also made it clear that projects to be funded by the excess funds, including several infrastructure projects, will create more jobs and accelerate the country's economic growth.
Hindi po ito illegal. Ito po ay naayon sa batas. Tumatalima lang kami sa batas na pinagtibay ninyo. At hindi automatic na namin ini-implement ito dahil binisisi muna namin kung may merito ba ang kautusan. Dumaan muna ito sa masusing pagrepaso ng DOF para malaman kung makakatulong nga ba ito sa paglago ng ekonomiya, kung ito ba ay legal.
Senator J.V. Ejercito earlier called for an investigation after reports of the transfer of PhilHealth's unused funds to the National Treasury. Ejercito expressed concerns about the significant amount of unspent funds, which he said could have benefited indigent patients. Meanwhile, PhilHealth says it will recommend to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to bring down the contribution rate after increasing it from 4 to 5%. Several measures receiving a green light from the House of Representatives with 177 affirmative votes. The measure seeking to legalize the medical use of cannabis or marijuana has been approved by the lower chamber. This aims to treat patients with certain medical conditions, but access to the drug will only be available by prescription and under the medical supervision of an accredited physician. House leaders now urging the Senate to immediately pass the bill, noting it has been languishing in Congress for 4 Congresses already. Now, also passed by the House of Representatives is a bill seeking to regulate the operation of motorcycle taxis and delivery services, as well as 3 other measures, including a bill seeking to strengthen the country's disaster risk reduction and management system. In other news, the Intellectual Property Office of the Philippines renewing its push for the inclusion of IPO rights or intellectual property rights in the country's school curriculum. The agency wants the topic to be integrated into an already existing school subject, emphasizing the importance for the youth to learn it since they're more engaged in content creation online. The IPO Philippines says it is in talks with the Philippine Regulation Commission to have intellectual property concepts be included in the board licensure examinations of teachers. The agency hopes creatives of all ages will register their works for copyright for their own protection. The Metropolitan Water Works and Sewerage System Regulatory Office now reviewing guidelines for determining rate adjustments for Metro Manila water concessionaires. Alvin El Chico with the details.
While her water bill more than doubled in the last months, Elvira admits she does not understand most of what is written there. She says the only portion she understands well are the amount due and due date.
Maintindihan lang natin is pabigat sa atin at magiging mas lalong kawawa tayo.
But the Metropolitan Water Works and Sewerage System Regulatory Office has announced it will bring back the Foreign Currency Differential Adjustment, or FCDA, most probably beginning last quarter of 2024. FCDA is a mechanism to recover costs due to fluctuations in foreign exchange in paying loans obtained by the MWSS and water concessionaires.
Because it's in the revised concession agreement as amended, never siya talaga nawala. The amendments to the RCA is retroactive. So it was retroactive up to July 2022.
MWSS Chief Regulator Patrick T. clarifies the FCDA does not automatically translate to an increase in the overall bill of consumers, as the peso may actually strengthen against the greenback, yen, euro, or other currencies.
If the adjustment is an increase of more than 10%, the MWSSRO can spread this out over a period of 2 years in order to cushion the impact to the consumers. Okay. If it is decreased, then we can immediately implement it because it is more beneficial to the consumers.
For UP professor and former MWSS chief regulator Dr. Joel Yu, the FCDA is a good revenue neutral mechanism to ensure that concessionaires are not burdened by additional costs which may also affect its service to customers.
Kung hindi ito ipapasa sa mga consumer, ito ay iaabsorb ng mga konsesyonaryo at mababawasan yung karampatang kita. So ano naman yung kailangan gawin? Itataas yung karampatang kita. Kung itataas yung karampatang kita, tataas na naman yung presyo na sinisingil sa ating mga consumer. Pareho lang.
But for consumers like Elvira, any additional charge brings strain to the family's budget.
Sana po kung di naman kailangan dagdag, wag na po, di ba? Hayaan na munang makarecover tayo sa katulad ko, may previous balance po ako. Ma-recover man lang yun.
The regulator assures consumers it will thoroughly scrutinize the FCDA filing of Maynilad and Manila Water before it is implemented. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine Airlines says it's also considering buying more planes as the travel sector further grows. But how will it compare to its rival's record-breaking aircraft purchase order? Jackie Pascual tells us more.
Following Cebu Pacific's announcement to snap up 152 Airbus aircraft, flag carrier Philippine Airlines is looking to make a similar move. PAL President and Chief Operating Officer Stanley Ng says, with the expected rise in travel demand and the construction of new airports, they need to boost their fleet soon since delivery usually takes several years.
Last year, we were supposed to study and make a longer term plan, because with all the development in our country as well, there will be a new airport, so new capacity will come in. So we have to prepare for that. We have to be ready. We cannot order planes when the airport is already online. So it's really thinking ahead also.
Nang says they are planning to purchase close to 100 planes.
We still have pending orders, but if you add those pending orders, maybe around that number also. Maybe, yes, a little less maybe.
PAL currently has 9 orders for the wide-body A350-1000 jets with an option to add 3 more for long-haul flights. And it also has 13 A321neo orders. Nang is also optimistic of the growth of the aviation sector with the construction of the Bulacan Airport as well as the privatization of the Ninoy Aquino International Airport.
Innovations will start coming in by September. So hopefully we can already see some innovations by the end of the year, because especially it's Christmas peak season and that's the best time for the travelers to enjoy those innovations that those are going to be implemented at the airport already.
He, however, says they will also monitor the possible rise in airport fees such as rental fees and other airport expenses. But for now, with a more positive economic outlook, Nang looks forward to PAL serving a direct flight to Seattle in October and a possible return to Europe next year. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
The Department of Migrant Workers seeking to capitalize on the Japanese labor market for overseas Filipino workers, with some 25,000 jobs up for grabs in Thursday's fair, part of the Philippine-Japan Friendship Week activities. DMW Secretary Hans Kakdak says, as of October 2023, the number of foreign workers in Japan reached a record of more than 2 million, with Filipino workers accounting for 11%, following Vietnam and China, mostly in the fields of engineering, software development, language teaching, interpreters, translators, and nursing care. Now, a study by the Japan International Cooperation Agency, or JICA, says Japan, with an aging population, will be needing over 4 million foreign workers by 2030 and close to 7 million by 2040 just to sustain its economic growth target. Trash on beaches is a problem almost everywhere. Over in Italy, researchers are developing a four-legged solution. Take a look.
This is Vero, or vacuum cleaner equipped robot. It's a robot dog that uses AI to identify cigarette butts on the ground and suck them up with vacuum cleaner attachments on each foot. Vero's developers hope it's the solution to one of the world's most pressing environmental problems.
I thought, why not place the feet in a good way that while you're going, you're doing something useful. We can quite easily distinguish what are cigarette butts, for example, and that's just a start.
Dr. Claudio Cimini is part of the design team at the Italian Institute of Technology in Genoa.
The Vero robot is really born out of almost a frustration of seeing how people are just flicking away and just leaving the cigarette butts on the beach in the small alleys. And these are places where machines can't access, like, let's say, the cleaning vehicles that can clean the roads very efficiently, and the squares on these little hard to access areas. There must be a different way, because if people need to pick them up by hand, one by one, this is obviously not a solution.
Vero uses a camera system and an algorithm to recognize its targets and plan a route. The team says it's successfully collected approximately 90% of cigarette butts in diverse environments. But Cimini says it can also help in removing other objects and larger litter.
Later on, it can be bottle caps or small pieces of plastic. Whatever you can train the neural network to recognize can be then sucked up. It can make a statistics of how much litter is there, in which area. And if it finds bigger objects like bottles and cartons of pizza, and whatever we find here in Genoa on the beach in these months when it's nice weather, then it can mark that, and later on either a human team or a different robot team can go and collect also the bigger items.